We are hearers, speakers, and doers of the Word of God. You're watching Sylvester Johnson Ministries on TVCN.
Hi, I'm Pastor Sylvester Johnson. Let's pray as we get into the Word. Father God, we just thank you today, Father, for your Word, and pray, Father, that it would go forth unhindered and uninterrupted by any hindrance or any external force. We thank you today, Father, that the entrance of your Word brings light. So our confession of faith is that light is coming because of the Word of God. In Jesus' name, amen. We can also think and have the mind of Christ. But first, let me say that the careful examination of the doctrine of faith or the instruction of faith, which is really what we believe as Christians, it can build an accurate core belief system within us that allows us to stand and to know what God is saying, what He is thinking, and His purposes that should be in our hearts. Or John 8 and 32, that you should know the truth or become intimately acquainted with the truth, and the truth that you know will set you free. You cannot be freed just by hearing the truth. You have to know the truth for yourselves. And so when you investigate the Word of God by studying the Word of God, looking at commentaries for yourselves, and trusting the Holy Spirit as He unveils the Word of God to you, then there's an accurate perception of not only who God is, but who we are in Christ. And so we want to look at a couple passages today that kind of solidifies that theme. And the first passage is in 1 Corinthians, the second chapter, and I want to read it from the New King James Version. Verse number 16 says, "For who has known the mind of the Lord, that he may instruct him? But we have the mind of Christ." In the Message translation, it kind of broadens it and gives us a better understanding of what that scripture is saying. He says, the unspiritual self, just as it is by nature, can't receive the gifts of God's Spirit. There is no capacity for them. They seem like so much silliness. Spirit can be known only by Spirit. God's Spirit and our spirits in open communion. Spiritually alive, we have access to everything God's Spirit is doing and can't be judged by unspiritual critics. Isaiah's question, is there anyone around who knows God's Spirit? Anyone who knows what He is doing has been answered. Christ knows, and we have Christ's Spirit. And then one more translation, the Amplified, says, who has known and understood the mind, the counsel and purposes of the Lord, so as to guide and instruct him and give him knowledge? But we have the mind of Christ, the Messiah, and do hold the thoughts, feelings, and purposes of his heart. So say this with me. Say, I have the mind of Christ, and I hold his thoughts, purposes, and pursuits in my heart. What simply means is I can think like God. I've been given the privilege to know how God thinks, not only how he thinks, but what he's thinking about every situation and every circumstance concerning me. I have the mind of the anointed one, who is Christ. So we know that Jesus is the Word of God. John 1 says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God, and the Word was with God. And also in the verse 14 says, and the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Jesus Christ is the Word, but he's not just the Word. He's the anointed Word, or he's the Word that has the anointing of God smeared or rubbed all over it. And so in every situation, we need to understand that by faith, we can know what God thinks. we can understand how God moves. We can know what method or which way, what direction we should go, because the mind of Christ has been given to us to discern and to decide which direction we should go. Now, I mention that for a number of reasons. Number one, because we cannot think like the world thinks. We cannot approach the world as just a fictional or non-fictional book. We have to approach the word as if it is God's thoughts, God's purposes, and God's plan for us. Number one, we have to rely on the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, according to John 3:16, is the Spirit of truth who leads and guides us into all the truth. And remember, John 8:32 says, and we should know the truth, and the truth we know, become intimately acquainted with, will make us free. Free to do what? Free to live as God intended us to live. But not only to live, but to have our means met, to have be empowered to be who God has called us to be. The Holy Spirit in us anoints the word of God in us so that we can think like God. So imagine a situation comes upon us, and at first the situation appears to be overwhelming. It appears to be impossible for us to conquer. Well, with the mind of Christ, what was impossible now becomes possible, because the Holy Spirit unveils to us the direction and the mindset we need to have in order to conquer that situation. But what the Holy Spirit does with the Word of God in us is give us the capacity to handle every situation, because we'll think just like God thinks. When God thinks, He thinks overcoming. When God thinks, He thinks prosperous. When God thinks, He thinks wholeness. How to bring us to an expected end. The purposes and the plans of God are not hidden from us. And I know the Bible says that there is safety in a multitude of counsel, but reserved in our spirit man, our renewed man, the image of God on the inside is those strategies and those pursuits of how to do and conquer everything that God has for us. Romans 8 says that the Spirit of God makes intercession for us. He begins to pray that we'll know the will of God, that we will overcome every weakness, every situation that seems insurmountable, every circumstance that overwhelms us. The Holy Spirit begins to pray the will of God, the plan of God, and the purposes of God. To me, that's good news. To know that I have the ability through the anointed Jesus Christ to think like God thinks, that I'll never be overcome in my mind, in my thoughts, in my thinking, to situations where I have not succumbed to. But I can overcome every challenge and every situation because I have the mind of Christ. This is all the time that we have. And I'm Pastor Sylvester Johnson, and you're listening to TVCN, where we are hearers, speakers, and doers of the Word of God.
You've been watching the Vision Christian Network, a network designed to help viewers hear the Word of God, speak the Word of God, and do the Word of God. Visit thevisioncn.tv today and increase daily in faith, love, and grace. Stay right here for more TVCN.